tonight. I'd like to welcome everybody this evening to the 2020 Mr. Brewster. It's always a great night for the community. I apologize for our technical difficulties there. I think you get the gist of the video, however. And so we are going to have some special guests here come up in a moment, which is always fun. But this is a great night for the Brewster community, so it's great to see such a huge crowd. We have some wonderful judges here. Let's give them a round of applause. Some first-time people, Coach Honey, Coach Oberg. Always Mr. Mulaney. Look how good he looks tonight. Look how wonderful he looks. All right, excellent. So tonight is going to be just a great evening for everybody, so sit back and really enjoy yourself. Hopefully it's going to be a lot of laughs. The fellows have been working really hard behind the scenes, and so they're going to give you a great night of entertainment. So at this point in time, we just want to remember and talk a little bit about why we're here. And the entire event is geared towards raising money for cystic fibrosis. The Salty Hands organization has been doing such a phenomenal job for years now. And so tonight is no different. And so what we normally like to do is talk a little bit about, or have actually, the person that started the program or started the organization, a gentleman that I coached, I was able to teach, And I humbly now call a friend, Brian McPartland. He is here with us tonight, and we're going to ask him to come up in a moment. Speak a little bit. We actually have a little presentation to make as well. And so we have somebody here representing the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation, and that's Eva. If she would mind coming up with Brian, that would be wonderful. And if we could invite them up on stage right now. We'd also like to invite Marla Egan, and our principal, Mrs. Horler. If you're here in the house, we'd like to invite you up as well. So please come on up. And we're going to turn it over to Brian here to talk for a moment, and also for the presentation as well.
Thanks again, everyone, for coming out tonight. Certainly a lot of people have worked very hard to put this together for the ninth year in a row. It's really exciting to see this continue to grow year after year. So obviously thank you to the judges, Mr. Cunningham, Salty Hands, the contestants, everyone here tonight, donors. Everyone's really made such a huge impact. Obviously we're here with Eva and Trina, also from the CF Foundation. And what we do here tonight is obviously a lot of fun, and we're making such a huge impact. The CF Foundation is here. Just last week, they were in Capitol Hill talking to representatives about access to care for people with CF. And another focus for the foundation is drug development. So in the last 9 years we've had Mr. Brewster, there have been 4 evolutions of a groundbreaking drug for people to significantly improve the quality of life for people with CF. So that's obviously tremendous. It's been just incredible stuff. I can't even talk about how thousands of people are benefiting every single day from the work we're doing here tonight, and just every day working towards a cure. So I really just wanted, from the bottom of my heart, thank everyone here and everyone that has contributed this year, any year, throughout my life, to adding years to my life and thousands of other people with cystic fibrosis. We really are making such a huge impact on so many people's lives tonight. So thank you.
Like Brian said, my name is Eva, and I'm part of the Greater New York Chapter, alongside Trina, of the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation. And on behalf of the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation and the town of Southeast, we would like to present the Salty Hands Club and the Brewster High School with proclamations for all of their hard work and continued support of the foundation and our mission. So thank you.
One last thing, I wanted to shout out the former participants of the Mr. Brewster Spectacular. Anyone that has participated in this before and is here tonight, please stand up, be recognized. We wouldn't be here without all your hard work. any former Salty Lake members also. Just, yeah.
Thank you, Brian. Thank you, Eva. That was wonderful. You know, this is just, as I said before, this is just such a great community event, and I just always feel so privileged and humbled to be involved in just a small part of tonight. So I really want you guys, again, to sit back and enjoy ourselves. We're going to introduce, again, our judges right now, just to make sure we all know who's going to be making the final decisions. We have Miss Sue Bohm. She's never been here before, never seen the show, correct? Very nice. Very good, very tough judge. We have Mr. Tom Mullane. He's here tonight. He actually, I believe he emceed the show as well, Tom, Mr. Mullane. So you can come up and help anytime you'd like. We have Mr. Mike Honey, Coach Honey. He's also new to the show. And then, believe it or not, we have Coach Oberg, Kristen Oberg, who's here, first year teacher for us. And the very first show, correct me if I'm wrong, Ms. Oberg, she was a sophomore at Brewster High School, sitting exactly where most of you are sitting right now, enjoying the show. Is that correct? That was for our very first show. So it's great to have her back now as a judge and an outstanding teacher some days. All right, now, so what we're going to do now is we're going to actually get an opportunity to see what you've all come here to see, which is our guys, you know, the people that come out, and they're going to entertain you for the next, you know, hour, hour and a half. So let's introduce our potential Mr. Brewsters. Here we go. First up, we have Mr. Austin Beal. Austin is a baller in every meaning of the word except maybe athletically. Ruled unfair to the competition in Section 1, you can find him often shooting Mad Jays after school and busting back more backboards than Shaq. Basketball isn't the only thing Austin loved. He is also a world-renowned pancake chef, despite being very close with the fire department. Austin is a man of many dreams. He hopes to become a computer scientist. He hopes to conquer his deathly fear of spiders. And of course, he hopes to become the next Mr. Brewster. Although he becomes off as a big tough guy, Austin has a soft spot, as shown by him knowing all the words to Lewis Capaldi's "Someone You Loved." He wishes the other contestants luck, but not too much. Mr. Austin Beal. Next up, we have Mr. Dan Bonadonna. He watched as his two older brothers took the crown. Dan is the baby of the family and gets scared whenever he loses sight of his mommy. You can easily see him from a distance, not by his presence, but because of the hideous orange Florida Gator sweatshirt he wears every day. Dan's favorite pastime is cuddling with his penguin pillow pet dubbed Goat, and nicknames to his list of skills. After spending hours perfecting his smile and selfie game, this Italian stallion still has time to mob out with the boys. That's in quotes. In the end, we wish Mr. Bonadonna, a.k.a. Danielson, a.k.a. Schman, a.k.a. Dan the Man, the best of luck in this competition. If he spent as much time practicing for this competition as he did staring at himself in the mirror, he'd be crowned already. Mr. Dan Bonadonna, everyone. Next up, we have Mr. Paul Catalano. And boy, sorry, oh, there we go. Take it easy. He's got a baseball season, my God. Before the show, Paul came up to me and told me to keep his bio short and sweet, just like Coach Honey. Wow, I didn't know that was there. I'm sorry, that was my bad. Paul Catalano, or Pauly Bex, as he's known on Instagram, lives by the words, "Whichever way you flip the sandwich, the bread always comes first." This upcoming entrepreneur believes he has the skills to take the crown of Mr. Brewster. When Mr. Bacon, Egg, and Cheese isn't smashing baseballs on the field, he can be found cuddling with his puppy. Yes, he does, in fact, have a soft side. This three-sport athlete doesn't spend his time swimming, but he is known as Michael Phelps on the court because of the sports goggles he rocks during games. Pause. There you go. Paul wishes all the contestants the best of luck because Paulie Bex came to eat. Paul Catalano, everyone. In the voice. The voice. That's a good job right there. Okay, get rid of that now. Poor construction on that, by the way. Next up, we have Aiden Coughlin. Come on out, Aiden. On April 13, 2002, Jim and Linda were finally given what they've always wished for, the perfect child. Even as a toddler, Aiden showed a flair for style. His go-to outfit has always been his sister's pink tutu, along with only one Disney princess high heel shoe. The outfit would be accessorized with upside-down sunglasses. His passion for fashion didn't end there. Aiden has a collection of Hanes white t-shirts that can accompany any of his dark-colored sweatpants. What better accessory than the Mr. Brewster crown? On the topic of style, let us not forget his car of choice, the 2008 Pontiac Vibe. Sporting a glistening silver coat, tropical green palm tree seat covers, and a signature broken passenger side hubcap, it's the epitome of chic. Ladies, anyone need a ride? Aiden Coughlin, everyone. Next up, we have R.J. Frankenberry. R.J. is a true gem of Brewster High School. When he's not busy tearing up the stage, he can be found listening to his girl, Cardi B, destroying some of his fellow contestants in Spike Balls, spending some quality time chatting with his cats, or, of course, binging the Bachelor. Or being a bachelor, I guess. RJ has many talents, from his ability to write an English paper 10 minutes before it's due and still get 100, all the way to his ability to play piano and serenade people, such as judges, to get them to do what he wants. He'd also like to remind the judges that he is the co-president of Salty Hands, the club behind this event. And although favoritism is not required, it is encouraged. Along with his excellent persuasion skills, RJ is smart, kind, and is known for his success with the ladies, even though it's exclusively, though, his many, 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 like, so many leading roles on stage. For these reasons, RJ is the obvious choice to bear the crown and responsibility of Mr. Brewster. RJ, thank you, everybody. Our next contestant is Jackson Mahoney. Come on, Jackson. When he's not on the soccer field or the wrestling mat, Jackson is in the stands showing his school spirit. Jackson claims that he has so much school spirit that he even picks his nose with a Brewster Bears foam finger. Odd. Jackson finds that he is most competitive when playing iMessage 8 Ball and hopes that he can bring that competitiveness to the 2020 Mr. Brewster competition. Outside of sports, Jackson uses his irresistible height to attract all the ladies. This seems pretty ineffective as he is barely 5'7", even when he's wearing his favorite set of heels. He asked me to tell this very short story about him. One day in his youth, Jackson, a self-proclaimed overachiever, walked into a bar. According to his parents, it wasn't set high enough. The end. Above all else in Jackson's life, including his friends and family, is his 1966 Pontiac Le Mans. He even decided that giving his car a wash was more important than finding himself proper shoes for the stage. To Jackson, leaving Mr. Brewster with a smile is more important than leaving with a crown, because the world always looks brighter from behind a smile. Isn't that nice? Jackson Mahoney, everyone. Okay, next up we have Eddie Mongs. Come on up. Since birth, Eddie has been training hard to become the next Mr. Brewster. He disguises this time on stage by participating in school plays. His natural dance moves give Shakira a run for her money. Now, he may not be the tallest contestant, but he certainly has the biggest heart. His love can be found in his culinary skills, cooking up mean cuisines at the Brewster Ice Arena. He always gets the groceries in one trip, so he has more time to serenade the ladies with his piano skills. He knows that this year's Mr. Brewster will be a tough competition, but he knows he can take home the gold. Eddie Mongs, everyone. Let's welcome to the stage, Malcolm Nordquist. Come on, Malcolm. Malcolm Nordquist is the definition of the saying, looks can be deceiving. Some have said that he looks like he walked out of a Wrangler commercial, which may be true. He never leaves home without his leather boots, blue jeans, and belt buckle. He even shows up to lacrosse practice and games sporting this look. Though you'll never find him listening to modern country music, he loves death metal. It reminds him of death. Makes sense. Is injury prone as they will ever be, most of the contestants have seen him hurt himself with a simple disregard for personal safety, as long as it's for a good time. This fun-loving nerd wants one thing above all in this competition, to win. Because if you're not first, you're last. Malcolm Nordquist, everyone. Next up, we have Jack Panagrossi. Come on out, Jack. What's curvy, interesting, and hard to understand? That's not Schroeder's wave function, that's Jack Panagrossi. Jack has had to endure an extremely tough childhood. No one understands what it's like to grow up a Bruins, Celtics, Red Sox, and Patriots fan in New York. Oh well, I wouldn't say that. It has never been easy, but whenever he's feeling down, he just reminds himself, at least I'm not a Jets fan. As an aspiring curler, Jack also excels at 5 other sports: cross country, track, baseball, basketball, and of course, golf. Jack's favorite fruit is not a strawberry or a blueberry, it's the library.
Yeah!
Oh. Thank you. Enjoyed that one out there. That's good stuff. You can often catch Jack in the library every day, 9 period, if you ever need help with your math homework or just general advice to help you through the journey of high school. Though he is straying from his typical tutoring routine for the next week. Instead, he'll be offering therapy sessions in the library for his fellow contestants after he brutally defeats them all. Jack Panagrossi. And let's finally welcome Nico Cerace, our last contestant. Crushed by his failed attempt to make the BHS volleyball tournament due to Coach Costaldo's insanely bad scouting, Nico, 21 Savage in quotes again, Cerace is still looking for the hole in his heart to be filled. He hopes winning Mr. Brewster will do just that. When asked about his outfit tonight, he completely blew off the question and continued to make TikToks with his beautiful escorts. Nico woos the ladies with his meticulous and godlike combination of elite level singing and dance moves. Some call him an angel. Some even go as far as saying he's the return of the Greek gods, but he really is just a Walmart version of Zac Efron. All we know is that if Nico cannot earn the Mr. Brewster crown, we will up his spirits by tossing him some spaghetti and meatballs. Nico's motto, if at first you don't succeed, make yourself feel better with some pasta. Nico Cerace, everyone. Thank you, ladies. Okay, now we've come to the time where we have the questions. They've been sealed. Right, Austin? Does Austin go first?
No.
Oh, that's too bad. I really wanted Austin to go first. Austin has been, if you don't know Austin Beal, he's one of the more nervous people I've ever met in my entire life. So the poor guy has been just really struggling for the past, you know, I would say at least 24, maybe 48 hours, Austin. What do you think? All right, so he's going to sit down there and wait for that question. So we're going to ask Mr. Nico, however, to come up. And we are going to give him a question. You need a sip. All right, do we want... Oh, boy. I believe it is. Hello? Just, yeah, hello? There you go. Improvise. There you go, my friend. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
I am ready. All right, buddy. Here we go. Okay, so the first question's for you, and it is the following. Pretend each one of the judges are in your position and are each competing. What would each one of their talents be?
Sorry, Mr. Blink.
His talent?
Definitely nothing with social studies. Definitely nothing with social studies.
You haven't been in my class, so that's not a surprise.
Yes! You better cover up, big guy. It's gonna be a rough one.
Mr. Blaine's special talent would be a baseball coach for his son in the Little League. Mrs. Bowen? Probably some type of like chemist on Breaking Bad or something like that.
So she's a drug dealer.
I wasn't saying that.
That's fair.
I would never say something like that.
I know, of course not. Got two more.
Mr. Honey? Save the lovely lady for last. Mr. Honey? Definitely nothing with lacrosse. Maybe something with football, you know? Maybe like grinding your teeth up here. You sit up here, grinding your teeth, you're like, I don't know, 5 minutes. Who knows? It's over, as I said, as I pronounce it. First, I would like to learn how to spell that before I give you a special talent. But your special talent would be... I don't really know you that well, so I don't know how to give you one. But I'd say a model. Oh.
Thank you, Nico. Good work, buddy. That was good. You finished up strongly right there. Mr. Jack? Front center, buddy. Is it on?
Yes.
Yes. Are you ready?
I am ready.
And for the record, by the way, I think being a Patriots, Red Sox, Bruins, and Celtics fan is the best thing in the world, so...
Brady, please stay.
Absolutely. I talked to him today. He's in. All right, now, since you're such a great student, I'm going to give you this question. You've decided to create a new course for BHS, okay? Practice begging Dr. Bandlow, Ms. Horler, Mrs. Cole, and Mr. Rodriguez to add this class. What is the class's name, and why does it need to be added as an elective? Remember, you are begging, so you better make your case.
Okay, so that's a good one, actually. I have two things come to mind. I'll start with the first one.
Wherever you want to start, buddy, go ahead.
So, I'm not going to name names or anything, but I'll just say initials. Mr. Ian Wong will sleep through chemistry every day. So I think nap class would be good. Woo! Napping helps productivity, right? Right? Power naps, that's good for you. Okay, that's the first option. The other one is fantasy football 101. There's a lot to fantasy football that I know, and I went through the hard thing. Who did I draft? I drafted someone bad. I drafted Andrew Luck, and then he retired a day later. So, there should be a class in which I can figure out who's going to retire the next day. So, I have the best team, and I don't lose 2 years in a row, because now I'm very salty that Josh Herman is beating me in fantasy football. Thank you.
You should be about Josh Herman, by the way. I would be very salty as well. That's an outstanding answer. Nice job, Jack. Thank you so much. Mal, you ready, buddy? All right, here we go. We get those out of the way, we're good. All right. You have been convicted of stealing a barbecue chicken sandwich from a local restaurant. Barbecue chicken. At your sentencing, the judge allows one person to speak on your behalf. Your mother is here to beg for leniency. What does she say?
Groovy.
That wouldn't be groovy, Your Honor.
I'm sorry. Was that it, or? Okay.
If anyone knows my mother,
I do not, so I'm going to go with the paperwork. Groovy it is. Thank you, Malcolm. Yeah. Eddie, you ready, bud? That's a tough act to follow.
Right,
I'm like nervous.
Are you nervous?
No. Yes.
Should we let you stand there for a couple more minutes just to make the nerves even get worse? Take a deep breath.
No, let's go.
Take a deep breath. You got it. All right. Okay. You are on the International Olympic Committee. The committee has asked you to choose one sport to remove from the Winter Olympics. Which sport is that going to be? And give us three reasons why. Please.
I'm not going to be honest. I don't follow winter sports, but...
You got to make something up then.
Actually, I don't follow any sports.
Perfect.
You know, there's a special place in my heart for curling, so I can't take that off. So I'd have to go skiing because it's just one below snowboarding. Sorry for any of the skiers. I'm sorry. That's my reason.
That's that's your main reason because it's not snowboarding.
Yeah. What's another sport?
Here we go. Help ice him out, skating. Please. Ice skating. There you go.
I work at the Brewster Ice Arena.
B-I-A-E!
That's the best answer I heard all night. Nice job right there. Fantastic. What's that person?
Spitball like some sport. I got nothing.
Okay. Whenever you're ready to end this, you just let me know. Luge,
downhill skiing, mogul, scalp.
There you go.
Okay, hockey. Everything you just listed gone.
Skiing.
For the reason of, I don't know what those names were.
Thank you, Eddie. I appreciate it. We're going to end with Tommy Hall. You did a great job. Jackson. How are you?
I'm good. I'm ready. I came out of the womb ready.
Wow. That's kind of weird. It's fair. Okay, you've been invited to meet your significant other's parents for dinner tomorrow. While at the dinner table, extremely foul gas sneaks out from... I didn't see this question, so I just started reading it. Extremely foul gas sneaks out from under you. Do you acknowledge it, and what do you say or do next?
So, I assume my significant other has wood floors, right? So first,
I would
assume that the chair just happened to squeak the wood floor, but you said insanely bad gas, so I'm thinking fill the room up. So that's not due to a chair. So, big honesty guy. So I'd be like, listen, went to Taco Bell today. Fun fact though, never been to Taco Bell. So I'd be honest, I'd say I went somewhere real bad, not treating the intestines good. Miss Blakey taught me about them today. And then I'd politely excuse myself, pull out my bottle of poopery and run to it.
I have a sneaky suspicion this might have happened to you. You sound pretty good.
It happened in class last year.
Oh, wow. There we go.
Several times.
Whoa.
He emptied the room.
Wow. A lot of truth being told tonight. There you go, Jackson. Good man. Nice job. Thank you. Jackson Mahoney, everybody. That's fantastic. RJ, you ready, buddy? I love how you knew how that was. That was outstanding. Thank you, Sadie. All right, RJ, you ready for a good question here?
I am.
All right, you've been pulled over in the village of Brewster. You drive.
Oh, I drive.
Okay. Well, the police officer has given you a window of opportunity to explain your excessive speed. Make it good.
Just to preface this, the first time I got a speeding ticket, I handed him my, oil receipt instead of my registration. So this is the best question I could have hoped for. So my friend Charlie, I think she's here tonight. She lives in the Heights, so I'd assume if I'm driving through the village, I'm probably heading to her house. And her dad, for those of you that know Mr. Fitzpatrick, he is a killer barbecuer. So I'm just going out on a limb here that assuming the average police officer likes barbecue. I'm flying through the village, probably going way too fast, like, I don't know. And he pulls me over, walks up to my car, and I say, look, oh, Charlie's dad is a police officer.
Took a little long to remember that, that's great. You're awesome friends, by the way.
I hand him my SBA card, and I go, look, there's barbecue on the line, sir. What should I say? Good day.
I agree. Nice job. I just thank you, my lord. Hey, come on, buddy. Hey, he looks good. All right. I hope the answer is as good as you look. Here we go. Okay. Good start. All right. Forget that you're on stage to win Mr. Brewster. You are now on stage to pitch your product to Shark Tank. Your product's name is Sassaroo.
Can you pronounce that again?
Sassaroo.
Sassaroo?
Yes, that's okay. The name of the product.
Okay.
What is it? And why should this audience buy it? Make sure you talk directly to your potential customers, please.
So the judges Shark Tank?
No, the audience, everybody here.
We're Shark Tank.
Okay, use the judges as your Shark Tank people, yes, please.
Okay, so I'm here to sell Sassaroo. Did I say that?
Sassaroo.
I'm selling 25% of my company, and I'm looking for $250,000. So Sassaroo is... product that you use to wax your car. And it's called Sassaroo because it makes your car invisible to speeding lights and tickets and stuff like that, so you can't get them.
I'm intrigued. Tell me more.
Okay, so how it works is, right, so you take a sponge, run on the car. No. And then...
Wait, show me again. Okay. I see it now.
You got the vision?
I have the vision in my head.
Okay.
It's clear.
Okay, so now I'm looking for 300,000. So what I'm looking for, right, is you apply it evenly upon the whole car, right? Then you let it dry for 72 hours, okay, indoors, it has to have a hair dryer. So I don't know how you're gonna do that. That's not my job. That's the consumer's job.
That's fair.
Right? Okay. All right.
Who doesn't know how to get their car indoors?
Like, come on, everybody's got a hair dryer in their garage. Like, come on, I can't park my car in the garage. It's okay. So then what we're gonna do next is we're gonna take it out, and we're just gonna drive.
I like where that ended. I think we're buying. I think we're buying.
250,000. That's a great job. Sassaroo, everyone. Shaking hands. Hi, Paul. Why don't you come on up, buddy? Paul Carolano, everybody.
How are we doing, Coach? How are you doing?
Good.
How's your night,
though? It's been very good. Paul Carolano, here we go. You ready?
I'm sweating a lot.
Okay. Thank you for that. Prom, as you know, is right around the corner. Choose a fellow contestant or somebody from the audience, if you'd like.
I'm not asking one into prom right now.
I'm sorry?
Do I have to ask someone to prom?
If you want, you can choose it. I mean, that's kind of the gist of the question, but I don't know. So, let's start over, okay? So, you're asking someone to prom. You need to choose a fellow contestant or someone from the audience, if you'd like. And you need to practice. So this is just a practice run for you. Your best promposal on that image. This is just a practice. We can bring someone up if you'd like.
All right, I'm just gonna bring someone up.
Yeah, bring someone up.
Just a little backstory real quick.
Yes.
Who should we bring up, though?
Oh, timeout.
Who should we bring up?
So I'm figuring out my escort, guys. I'm figuring out my escort before. I'm asking around. And I ask my mom to come out on stage with me. And she gives me a fat no. So, Kathleen, would you join me up on stage?
She is not going to like this at all. This is Galano. Are you here? Here she comes. This is Galano. Is very upset right now.
What's cooking, Ma? Huh? Oh, you're so
high. I know. Hello. I feel nervous actually right now, so I'm gonna move over here.
So I'm proposing to my mom.
Practicing, yes.
Okay.
Gentlemen, give her a seat, jeez.
She doesn't know. Alright, here we go. How's the deal, Bruce? Here we go. I'm going. My future date, how the sun glistens the beauty of the face of no makeup.
Wow.
This is awesome. Walk into the room and just eyes light up and just eyebrows just through the roof. Just can't even split it anymore. And then big hot air balloon prom question mark.
I'd love to go to the prom.
I mean, if you want my opinion, you had me at no makeup. That was a winner.
Mrs. Cat.
Yes, Mrs. Cat. Wow. The better of the Cat. There we go. Oh, hi, Danny. Daniel. How are you feeling tonight, buddy?
I'm good.
Are you sure?
Can I just like stop this all for 1 second?
I would love you to.
Is my man Billy Finn here today?
Oh boy.
Where's my man Billy Finn? Where is he? Can we get a spotlight on my man Billy?
Wow. We're going with spotlight.
Please. Tonight is Billy's birthday.
Is it?
Yes,
it is. Who
cares? Alright, I think it would be a wonderful idea if you said happy birthday to him. Yeah. Boys, come on.
I think you should just. Yeah, there you go. Wow. Billy, this one's for you, buddy.
Happy birthday to you.
Cha cha cha.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Billy.
Happy birthday to you.
That was good, Danny. Thank you.
It's a good scholar, no?
That was. Billy, happy birthday to you, my friend. All right, now, here we go. If you were running for President of the United States, very possible, which fellow contestant would you want as your vice president?
Vice president.
Okay. Doesn't end there, though. Okay. Who would be your opponent?
Opponent, easy, RJ Harger. I mean, RJ Frankenberg. Sorry, RJ. I'm a little nervous tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
So the opponent is already, Mr. Frankenberry is
without
the opponent.
Without a doubt, 100%. No, kid's ruthless.
You're in trouble already. Based on this audience, you're in trouble. All right, now. And also, what would be the first law you would try to pass? So first of all, we need vice president, and then your law.
Paul, get up here.
Vice president right here. Two good-looking men right here, right?
Well-rounded, that's it.
So Paul. Boys, actually, this goes all to all the boys. Boys. The number one law. What's the number one rule for Saturday, boys? Saturday's for the boys, you know? So I'm president. I'm elected 11:59 p.m. midnight, because we get rowdy at midnight, coach.
Yeah, you like that. I know you do.
So it's 12 a.m. Me and Paul and Cap, we're sitting in the Oval Office, right?
We're getting hyped, because we're always hyped, right?
And I call my boys on FaceTime, because now you can do group FaceTime. I don't know if you're up with the technology.
I do it all the time. Coach Honey and I.
I call the boys. And I'm like, yo, boys, rule number one, Saturdays are for the boys. Save the girlfriend for Sunday. Thank you very much.
Very nice, Danny. Thank you so much. There he is, everyone. Mr. Austin Beer. Not much, man. What's going on with you? But yeah, there's the spotlight. Put it right on his face. Just, yes.
It's definitely not as easy as it made it look.
No, not at all. But you're gonna do really well, Austin.
That's really much.
You know, just don't mess it up. Everybody's gonna remember if you do.
I heard this was on YouTube.
So it's preserved for years. Actually, my daughter was watching previous ones the other night, so she's gonna make fun of you as well. Which is gonna be outstanding. Yes, Mr. Mullane.
Quick question while I have you up.
Yes.
This is a rare opportunity.
Of course.
3 years ago, you missed a homework assignment.
Wow.
I was sick that day.
Okay.
Congratulations, by the way. You have just won the lottery and received $5 million.
Fantastic.
Okay. However, here's the problem here. Cousin Billy is asking...
Is it Billy Finn?
Yes. It's his birthday, and he's asking for $1 million to buy a pontoon houseboat to live on the land. Aunt June is asking for $1 million for a piece of gum Brad Pitt once chewed. And Grandma is asking for $1 million for 5 hairless cats. You have to choose one of them to give the money to. Who do you choose and why?
The hairless cats.
Why?
Why not? Hairless cats are cool. We got a long one someday.
That went exactly like I thought it would. Austin, you're the best. Thank you so much, buddy. And I think we've asked everybody a question. What do we think, ladies and gentlemen, so far? I mean, and so at this point in time, we had a little contest that went on over the course of last week, which was these gentlemen had to submit some baby pictures. And then the faculty and staff were able to then choose, I think students as well, I'm not sure, were able to choose which they thought was the cutest baby. And so we have a little gift card for that individual. And so the cutest baby award, who do we think it is? Do we think? We're going with Dan? How? Well, you're absolutely correct then. It is Dan Bonadonna. He was voted as the cutest baby. Nice job. So at this point, I think, we have a little nice gift. Absolutely, buddy. I have a gift for you though first.
Jeans. I'm sexy.
I'm sorry, what?
This wasn't sexiest baby. This was...
No.
Clear.
Because, like, as a baby, I was cute, but I know the first thing coming out of Coach Honey's mouth is what happened. I went from cute to sexy. Like, that's what happened. What happened?
Nice shot, man. Cute baby. So at this point in time, we are going to ask these gentlemen to remove themselves off stage because they are going to prepare themselves for a wonderful spectacle that they're going to put on for you. So we're going to ask everybody to kind of sit tight for a moment, and they're going to prepare themselves for, a wonderful dance routine. So we'll be back in moments.
Maya Marie Zimmer, a native of Lutcher and a resident of Paulina, peacefully entered into eternal rest at the age of 24 on Tuesday, July 21st, 2015 at 6:50 p.m. Surrounded by her loving family and many devoted friends. From the time Maya was three months old, when she was first diagnosed with cystic fibrosis, until her beautiful departure, she lived her life to the fullest, never allowing her illness to prevent her from pursuing her dreams and achieving her goals.
They met at high school. Jobs were struggling in school. Maya was in honors and offered to tutor Jarvis. They hit it off and they became high school sweethearts.
You know, she was the captain on the dance team. I was the captain on the football team. It was, you know, one of those stories that you always hear about, you know, the leader on this and the leader on that. Obviously, they're meant to be together.
Cystic fibrosis is a genetic disorder that attacks the respiratory and digestive systems. While advancements have increased life expectancy, there is still no cure for CF.
She always like had like a cough, you know, type of, you know, and, you know, and she never really would tell me why, and, you know, probably about, I would say probably about a year went by in our relationship, you know, before she finally like told me like what was happening and told me about CF. And, you know, immediately I started crying because, you know, at the time, you know, my high school sweetheart, you know, my love, the person that I think I'm gonna be with for the rest of my life, told me the life expectancy rate is like 31 years old, 32 years old.
Despite Maya's complications from CF, she pursued her passion for dance.
I just remember going to his high school football games, and I remember, you know, after her performing, you know, during halftime, you know, that they had to immediately, you know, get her some oxygen.
After every time she danced, like, it took minutes for her to just catch her breath. But it was one of those things that, you know, she loved so much that, you know, even if it killed her, like, she was gonna dance because that's what made her feel free. That's what made her feel alive. And, you know, she did it for as long as she could.
Maya went on to dance for the New Orleans NBA franchise. But as her condition progressed, Landry remained devoted and determined to help his high school sweetheart.
As I sat with her, talked with her, saw her do the breathing treatments, saw her take the medication, the constant doctor visits and stuff like that, I just realized that if God continued to put me on the journey that, you know, I believe I was on, that if I had the opportunity with the platform, you know, that I'll continue to go out there and talk about CF. And that's really been my promise to her.
Following Maya's passing in 2015, Landry kept his promise, honoring her memory and advancing the fight against cystic fibrosis.
We asked him to get involved in our national walkathon, which is Great Strides, and he brought the teammates out.
I mentioned to them when we were at practice, you know, about this and how he was affected by it, and they came to show some support.
He cares. He really is in this to cure this disease.
This past offseason, Landry was traded to Cleveland, but on the night he was dealt to the Browns, he paid one last visit to Hard Rock Stadium to host the Jarvis Jam.
Hey, how's it going?
A charity event benefiting the South Florida Cystic Fibrosis Foundation.
I just want to thank you for all you do with CF. My nephew has CF.
Thank you guys for coming out tonight. And just a part of the reason why I'm here, I was affected by this early on in high school, where I lost a girlfriend to CF. You know, my promise to her was just, you know, raise as much awareness about it as possible, talk about it as much as possible, you know, and now I even have a new city to talk about it in and, you know, continue to find the looks for a cure.
She's looking down, I know, happy, I think, that we're trying to, you know, better everybody's tomorrow that's fighting with CF. And if there's a cure out there that can be put together to save lives, then, you know, I would feel like part of my promise was to be at least on that train and, you know, trying to go that way.
Yeah.
suicidal. You said it's over. Damn all these beautiful girls. They only wanna do what you heard. They know that you're suicidal. Suicidal. They said it's over.
Let's put a the way you got me playing the field. So baby, give me that hook. I'm gonna give you that hit. My hands through my throat. I'm saying, don't do it close. That's why they still got a red. It's the remix to ignition. I can crash out the kitchen.
Tell him I told no stars, please. Soon as I can go, then he got him.
I want these new Pikachu. Yellow Ferrari like Pikachu. I got them waiting and watching what he gonna do. Trying to be what I do, trying to steal all of them.
Recognize at this point too a couple of lovely ladies that put that all together for you. If they would stand up for us, I think they're up there. Put the spotlight on them for a little bit. They had a lot of patience to teach that guy, all these guys that dance. There was a lot to it, so thank you, ladies. That was tremendous. Nice job, gentlemen. So we'll ask you to go off stage. Excellent work. Get a little drink of water too. Thanks, buddy. Job, Eric. Okay, so at this point in time, we're just getting ourselves prepared for the talent portion, or lack thereof, of the gentleman here. And so again, what we always want to talk about when we come to an event like this, this is now our ninth year doing this, Mr. Brewster competition. So it's been such a huge success over the course of the years, and it's grown so much. And the reason why it's grown so much is because of the efforts of all our awesome students and how the community comes out and supports us, for this particular night. But it really comes, behind the scenes with the Salty Hands group. They do such a great job of just making sure that everything's running smoothly tonight, but throughout the course of the year, they're just making sure people are aware of what's going on. So, when you look at the history of this particular night, we started back in 2012, and it was a great night for everybody because we raised almost $4,000. Which is a tremendous amount for a one-night event, and it was such a huge success, and from there it's only grown. So if you look at the progression over the course of the years, to compare 2012 with last year, which was 2019, we raised almost $60,000 last year alone. We don't know exactly what the total is this evening yet, but we will certainly get those numbers for you before the end of the night. We're totaling up the ticket sales and things like that, adding those things in. But it's promises to be obviously another great night for us. So again, it's all due to the support of the students that are involved in this, but also you members of the community who come out for this great night and pack this place every year. It's always sold out, and it's just such a wonderful event. So what we want to do right now, and I think he's preparing himself, we have our first, he's ready, we have our first talent portion of our contest. So it's going to be Jack Panagrassi. He's going to come out and do something just absolutely wonderful for you. So we're going to invite Jack to come out and perform. So enjoy, Jack.
All right, strap in, this is gonna take a while. So, I'm Jack Panagrassi, as you heard, and I can't sing or dance, as you just saw. But, no but, that's it. However, I am quite good at throwing paper balls into the garbage can during calculus. I was supposed to go in. So I'm good at that. In other words, I'm very good at distracting the class when they're trying to learn about the Taylor series. So, what's the Taylor series? I don't know, I don't pay attention. But I do know that it's not important. Don't tell Matt. I mean, it isn't. It's not gonna teach me how to do my taxes or how to represent myself in my insider trading case. Oh, does anyone know a good lawyer, by the way? Because I know two, they live in my house. But, don't tell them, they charge a steep rate. Like, no family discount? Anyone know one? Elaine? He does, he knows one. That's okay, I'll figure it out. I can do a lot of things people told me I couldn't do. I took up piano at a late age. I'm Asian and I can grow a beard. And I became a Patriots fan in New York, as you heard in my bio. Okay, so the first sort, cap. Oh, sidebar. Cap means lie. Remember that. But doesn't it look nice? This is no shaving since mid-December, fun fact. Like I was saying, I'm a Patriots fan, and before you start throwing things at me, hear me out. It's been rough. It's been over a year. Do you know what that does to a kid? This past Super Bowl is really weird. I forgot what it was like to not be screaming my head off and throwing things around the living room for 3 hours. Sorry, mommy. My track coach, Coach Scalia, huge football fan. Oh, speaking of track, last week I had a huge PR. I can do a mile in less than 45 seconds. In my Subaru Impreza. Wait, best part. I did it right out there on Foggintown. Yeah. My mom's in the back shaking her head. She's never gonna let me drive her Jeep again. Mr. Fien's in the house, now my insurance is gonna go up. So, I planned on running in college. I really hope Harvard accepts me. I'm kidding, I didn't apply to Harvard. I'm actually too good for Harvard. I'll be attending the University of Oxford next year per request of the Queen. Wait. Best part, it's all cap. Ah, callback. Who is listening? Moms and dads, remember that? If you want to communicate with your high school age children. Mr. Mullane likes cap. He's going to incorporate that into his lessons now. So Joseph Stalin would often cap. Oh, King Henry VIII? I guess you could say he was the king of cap. No, you don't like that one? So I got cap from rap music. Last story, I promise. I got cap from rap music. And back in October, I told my mom, hey Tina, oh, Tina's my mom. I was like, hey Tina, me and the boys are gonna go see a concert. And she was like, oh great, who are you going to see? And I was just like, just a rapper. She was like, okay, well, what's his name? So I told her Jeffrey Lamar Williams. And she was like, no, what's his rapper name? So I said Young Thug. And she was all like, ugh. I get it, you don't want, a responsible parent doesn't want her half-Asian suburban boy going to a Young Thug concert. Like, he doesn't sound too nice. I know she would have much rather have me go to the Wiggles or someone. But at least I didn't go to Ski Mask the Slump God. He sounds dangerous. Can't believe she didn't believe Jeffrey Lamar Williams, though. Like, there's some rappers with normal names. Travis Scott, Kendrick Lamar, Meek Mill. Like, he can't be that bad, right? He's Meek. He's not Aggressive Mill. Aggressive Mill, I like that. I might take that. Can I come out here? Can I walk? Can I do this? I'm out of the light. I'll come back. I'm gonna turn this into my Netflix special. How do you like the sound of this? Jack Panagrossi, taking way too long. I just want to see Austin Beale, a Netflix original. On that note, I know some of you have dinner reservations, including myself. I know some of you want to see Beale, including myself. So, so I will leave it at that. Thank you for laughing with me, at me. If you didn't think I was funny, fine. I don't care. That's okay. All I know is that even if I don't win tonight, I can still win the NFC East.
Good job. Okay, so our next talent is going to be a duo here. We have Malcolm Nordquist and Aiden Coughlin coming up. And we're going to do something wonderful for you. So Aiden and Malcolm, come on out. Mr. Brewster Hopeful, that's Jackson Mahoney. And he's going to do something just unbelievable. Jackson, the floor is yours. Do you need the microphone? Okay.
Get washed away like the snow and the rain. It's been a load of compromising on the road to my horizon. But I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me. And a star-spangled rodeo, like a rhinestone cowboy, getting cards and letters from people I don't even know, and offers over the phone.
Thank you all, you've been amazing.
So next up, we have another duo for you. We have Mr. Austin Beale coming back, and he's going to team up with R.J. Frankenberry. Fan favorite. Sadie, go ahead. So these two gentlemen are going to come out and again perform together. And here they are, R.J. and Austin. Let's hear it.
Austin and I will be facing off an award. We will be painting each other while doing the Chubby Bunny Marshmallow Challenge. Who can fit more marshmallows in your mouth at once? And once you can't fit more, you have to stop painting.
My tips is, it's not bad.
have to show you our masterful creation.
Mine is from Mr. Mullane.
So our next talent, major talent, is going to be Nico Serais, and he's performing by himself, and he's gonna do something spectacular. Nico? If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go. Keep you around my arm, girl, you'd never be alone. And I can be a gentleman, anything you want. If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go. I'd never let you go. Yeah, tell me what you like, yeah, tell me what you don't. I can be a buzz light, yeah, fly across the globe. I don't ever wanna fight, yeah, you already know. I'ma make you shine bright like you're laying in the snow. What? Girlfriend, girlfriend, you could be my girlfriend. You could be my girlfriend into the whole world. Make you dance, do a spin in the twirl. Voice going crazy on the beat like a whirlwind. Sweat.
I'd like to be anything you want. Hey, girl, let me talk to you. If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go. I keep you around my arm, girl. You'd never be alone. And I can be a gentleman, anything you want. If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go. I'd never let you go. So give me a chance. You're all I need. You're all I need, girl. I just wanna love you as your boyfriend. I never let you go. Keep you around my arms, girl. If I was your boyfriend, I never let you go. I never.
I'm sorry, Mr. Mullane, I had some technical difficulties there. I was absolutely positive backstage you were the guy. Those roses had your name all over them. I'm sorry, where's that young lady right there? Okay, did you say yes? Oh, that was nice. Okay. So it's a great night all the way around, all right, outstanding. So thank you, Nico, wherever you are. That was outstanding, good job out of you. So next we have another dynamic duo coming to the stage, and it's going to be Danny Bonadonna and Paul Bonadonna. Yeah. So Danny, Paul, good luck, buddy.
Say you're going to LA, I count down till you call me. It's just one of those things that you do when you're lonely. And you're all about the chase, but you won't ever let me catch you. And I wish I was the same, but I know I'm gonna let you in again. And when I do, it's gonna hurt like hell, but you don't mean to. That's what I tell myself, but why you gotta be so heartless? Silent.
Everyone on their feet for this one. Get up. Everyone up. Let's go. Let's go.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York. Dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaking, but I gotta keep trying.
Yes, please.
Mr. Mullane and I are going to need our pants back later. So.
Yes. I knew they raided your closet. That's your evening wear, as they say, when you like to head out and step out. You look good. Absolutely, Mr. Mullane. Okay, so we have our one final presentation or talent for you this evening. And it's Eddie. Are you ready? All right. He's behind the stage. Eddie's going to perform for us. So your time is now. Good luck, buddy.
Thank you.
So, now that you've seen the Q&A and you've now seen the talents of these fine gentlemen, we're going to now ask our judges to do their thing. And while we're doing that and asking the judges to work incredibly hard, earn their pay tonight, we're going to have several thank yous. And so before we announce our Mr. Brewster winner, we'd like to thank a few special people who are a huge help in running the show this year. First, as always, our dance team ladies did an awesome job. We saw them before. They spent many hours a week, starting in January, organizing the boys to put this dance together, and it wouldn't have been successful without them. So we need Nicole Oshevsky, Sophia Ruggiero, and Alexis Shelley to come on up. We have a little gift for you, ladies. Let's hear it. Come on up. Come on. Nice job. Jackson, these fine gentlemen are going to give you something nice. Thank you so much. Thank you, ladies. Great dance, as always. Next, thank you to our 2020 Salty Hands president, Megan Feehan, our presidents, Megan Feehan and R.J. Frankenberry. They worked with Miss Egan all year to help run Salty Hands lead meetings and prepare for Mr. Brewster, even if R.J. was more so preparing for his performance tonight, right? They have both been amazing presidents this year, and we're so sad to see them leave. So if we could ask Megan to come up here as well. There's RJ as well. Thank you guys. Outstanding. There's some flowers for you. Well deserved. Our next thank you is for our Salty Hands Club advisor, Marla Egan. This was her second Mr. Brewster as advisor, and she did an outstanding, amazing job. She put so much work into making Salty Hands. And this night runs smoothly. There he is. Thank you, Paul. And we couldn't give her that thanks call she does for the club. So thank you, Ms. Egan. Another wonderful show. Appreciate it. Thank you, Paul. We would also like to thank Lisa McPartman. While she certainly doesn't have to, she attends every Salty Hands meeting with her son, Brian. Her and Brian have inspired so many, and no amount of thanks could add up to what they have given all of us. So we'd like to invite Lisa up here as well. This has been a regular life of hers for years, and it's been the lifeblood of this Salty Hands program. Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, Brian. And Brian's out there, too. And also, another huge thank you to Anne-Marie Chalmers. The show can never run like it. She spends countless hours behind the scenes, making sure every detail is forgotten. She's tough. She's definitely tough. But she is incredibly dedicated and hardworking on the show, and it's one of the main reasons why the show is such a huge success every year. Thank you, Ms. Chalmers. We would also just like to acknowledge the Salty Hands Club and its officers. Can everyone at Salty Hands stand for a minute, please? Please stand up. Yes, absolutely. Thank you for your dedication and making your flight run smoothly, along with all the hard work put in throughout the year. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, there. Outstanding work. Thank you so much. Shout out to Nora Palladino for raising the most money of all the club members. She raised $450. Go, Nora. Come on up here. We have a good talk to you. Where's Nora? Nora Palladino. She's out raising money as we speak. Outstanding. Nora's not here. Okay, we'll make sure she gets it. Oh, no, she is coming. Okay. Don't yell at her. Hi, Nora. Big hand for Nora, please. And the last little thank you that we would love to extend is to our crew backstage. They do a tremendous job with our lights, our sound, all the music with the curtains and all the things that we need to make the show run smoothly. So the group backstage, they're still doing their job, so they can't come out right now, but just give them a big round of applause as well, please. So at this point in time, we will be having our winners, or actually all of the boys, coming back out on stage, and then we'll have an opportunity to recognize our first, second, and third place, Mr. Brewster. So come on out, gentlemen. There's the phone. First of all, I think it's important to note, I mean, look at all the talent up here and all the people that have put their time and efforts. All these guys have really gotten behind this movement. Mr. Brewster has taken a life of its own. And this class of 2020 right here is no exception. They've done a wonderful job. So I think we should give them all a round of applause one time. As we've said before, you know, it truly does take a village, you know, when it comes to great events and things like this. And so they've all played a part, you've all played a part. And so, you know, I've just been handed our tonight's total, which is just off the charts here. So tonight's total, including the door, is $79,900. $80,000 is raised for a tremendous cause, and as you heard Brian say before, you know, there's been four, I believe, breakthroughs since we've even started, Mr. Brewster, so this is just an amazing, amazing Herculean effort by these gentlemen. $80,000, gentlemen, or ladies and gentlemen, it's just tremendous. Thank you, guys. I really do appreciate it. Just to give you a little bit more context, that, you know, for the past 9 years now, that brings our total to $337,737.88. By these gentlemen, as well as their predecessors, we have Mr. Brewster. I think I saw Eddie out there. There he is. He's obviously a part of that, as well as all of you. So thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. What a great effort it's been for the past 9 years, and hopefully it continues. I don't see why it would not. Okay, so thank you so much. So we have also, just to give you an idea individually, how these lovely gentlemen here worked hard to raise money over the past several weeks. Just to give you some numbers there as well, we have Sam Lowe at $160. Outstanding job. Hey, every bit counts. Every bit counts. It's not about necessarily the top. Eric Mulatto, $167. Eric, thank you so much. Step forward, please, Eric. Thank you. We have Josh Lowe at $195. Thank you, Josh. Ryan Bonamici at $614. We have Eddie Moms at $1,572. Thank you so much. We're into the fourth figures. Aiden Coughlin, we have $1,797. Outstanding. You got it. Jack Panagrassi, we have $1,964. That's for the comedian. Nice job. Malcolm Nordquist, we have $2,286. Austin Beal, we have $2,724. Jackson Mahoney, where are you? $3,022. Nice job, Jackson. Excellent work. And then we have Paul Catalano. Paul Catalano raised $6,630. That's not bad for him right there. And then we have our top three individuals that raised the most money, starting with number three. We have Mr. Nico Cerais. He raised $9,300. Nice job, Nico. Excellent work, buddy. And then we have our top two, R.J. Frankenberry, raised $20,569. Staggering number, R.J., where are you? Unbelievable. Excellent work. And then we have our top earner, for this year's Mr. Brewster, was Dan Bonadonna, raised $25,000. All right, Megan has the sash, so now I think it's time to award the sash to the individual that has won the contest this evening, as we said before. However, look at all this. I mean, just listen to those numbers. It's really inspiring, so thank you. So, well, I guess he's going to win. Outstanding. So, our winner in our 2020 Mr. Brewster is none other than Dan Bonadonna.